Parks are wonderful places to study animals and habitats. And the reason is these are relatively protected lands.
Cabrillo National Monument.
Capitol Reef National Park.
Guadalupe Mountains.
Swan National Park.
Zion National Park.
Chaco Culture National Historical Park.
Craters of the Moon National Monument.
Rocky Mountain National Park.
Historical parks.
The Mojave Desert.
Yellowstone National Park.
Glacier National Park, one of our most treasured parks in the country.
And so I think the first step is, you know, they call it inventory and monitoring. The first step is let's find out what we've got. What are the resources in the park?
Grizzly bears, Clark's nutcrackers, and squirrels.
The water, what the air, our plants and animals.
Octopi, the fun things, sea anemones.
A beautiful alpine lake or a remote spring in the middle of the desert.
Limpets.
Pinyon juniper.
Natural dark skies.
Caddisflies.
Biological soil crust.
Dragonflies.
Huge sycamore trees.
Elk. Deer, beaver,
the jaguar,
vegetation and soils,
whitebark pine, wetlands,
these incredibly charismatic, slippery, slimy things.
And then once we know what we've got, let's figure out how's it doing? How are these resources doing? Are they healthy? Are they unhealthy? Are they maybe having some problems?
Buffalo grass brings fire into the desert and into your neighborhood.
Exotic plants, weeds, non-native species.
And this tamarisk, it just loves to soak up water out of the ground.
Blister rust.
Elk.
Mountain pine beetles.
Climate change.
As the climate warms.
Changes in climate.
As temperatures have warmed.
So we've had some very, very destructive fires.
Wildfires.
Exploration and development of natural gas.
Chemical compounds.
Hatchery influences.
Rocks not.
In order to protect and preserve, you have to know what you have, which would be the inventory part, and when what's happening to it over time. That's the monitoring part of it.
So what my job is to go and to figure out what is there, how much of it, and what state is it in? Is it increasing, decreasing? What's going on?
And that's done by sending scientists out into the field and taking measurements.
A lot of things are changing.
Change is good, can be good, but at the same time, understanding why it's changing or how it's changing can help us make decisions on maybe it's good change, but sometimes it could be bad change.
And in fact, talking to resource managers who work at that park and have worked there a long time, I think they actually have felt grief for the changes they've seen going on.
It's interesting to think about what might be driving the change that we're seeing in the vegetation.
Okay.
And whether it's an early warning of bigger changes to come.
Doing something about it is a little bit difficult because unfortunately we do tend to be more observers of the change that's happening, but by being observers we can inform those that may be able to do something about it.
One of the neat things that we figured out is that where they grow matters, and some trees grow in finer textured soils, and in some cases those trees and those soils don't die when the beetles are still present. So we can use that information to think about where we might want to plant trees in the future or where they might go in the future, and those would be the places where the trees might survive. So that's our reason for hope.
I'm a creature of the water.
I'm a big history buff.
I have what I think is a dream job.
I am indeed a nerd for nature.